Welcome to tonight's episode of Public Domain Theater. Comedian Jerry Seinfeld once used to do a thing with, you know what? I can't do this without the teleprompter.
Comedian Jerry Seinfeld used to do this great bit on the difference between winning the gold medal and the silver medal in the Olympics. You come in first, greatest guy in the world. You come in second, never heard of him. The same analogy can be applied to other things. It is widely known that the first person to ever break the sound barrier was Chuck Yeager. But how many can tell you that the second person to do it was James Thomas Fitzgerald? Many people know that the first video ever shown on MTV was the Buggles' Video Killed the Radio Star. However, they may not be able to tell you that the second one was Pat Benatar's You Better Run. What was the first fully animated feature-length film? If you answered Walt Disney's Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, you'd be right. And quickly, what was the second one ever made? No one? I'll give you a hint. It's based on Jonathan Swift's classic novel, travels into several remote nations of the world in four parts by Lemuel Gulliver, first a surgeon and then a captain of several ships. It's also known as Gulliver's Travels. Max and Dave Fleischer wanted to create a fully animated feature-length film as early as 1934, soon after Walt Disney announced the production of Snow White. Paramount Pictures, who had released the Fleischer's Popeye and Betty Boop cartoon shorts, among others, told them no. After Snow White became such a success, they changed their tune. They even had a studio built in Miami Beach, Florida, and production on Gulliver's Travels began in 1938. Paramount pushed for a Christmas 1939 release date, which meant that the Fleischers had about one-third of the time that Disney did. When animating the character of Gulliver, they used a technique that they created called rotoscoping. The process involves filming an actor live and then tracing over them one frame at a time. The other characters are traditionally hand-drawn, which makes it seem like the characters exist in two different films. But it serves to highlight the differences between Gulliver and the Lilliputians. As if the 200-foot height difference didn't already do that. The rotoscoping process must have been very expensive. That's the only reason why I can think of why Gulliver is not seen until the film is nearly half over, with the exception of the opening scene when he crashes onto the beach. In fact, the character with the most screen time is Gabby, the town crier. But Gabby's Travels sounds like a spoiled socialite's show on the Travel Channel. Max and Dave Fleischer must have seen something in that character, though. In 1940, they began production on a series of Gabby cartoons, also getting a spin-off series called Animated Antics with a trio of spies, Sneak, Snoop, and Snitch, and the kooky carrier pigeon Twinkle Toes. Gulliver's Travels was a huge success and was nominated for two Academy Awards, Best Original Score and Best Original Song for Faithful Forever, losing both to some obscure film called The Wizard of Oz or something like that. Anyway, Walt Disney said of the film, "We can do better than that with our second-string animators." The Fleischers did one more feature-length film, 1941's Mr. Bug Goes to Town. However, business-related problems, studio debt, and the escalating sibling rivalry between Max and Dave prevented any other productions. Well, at least they left us with tonight's film. The, according to Jerry Seinfeld, never-heard-of-them medal winner in the feature-length animated film Olympics. Get your popcorn and your soda, make note of the nearest emergency exit, and switch off your cell phone or pager. Public Domain Theater is proud to present Max and Dave Fleischer's production of Gulliver's Travels.
Thank you. Just a couple of old Dan Cupids, I think.
Your Majesty, the wedding tinks are here.
There's a giant on the beach, there you go.
Exquisite taste. Exquisite.
Roses, freesias, rhododendrons, ranunculus, snapdragons, and daisies. Pretty posies, aren't they?
Beautiful blooms. Beautiful.
Yes, we like it. That is Faithful, the song of Lilliput. It will be played at the wedding tomorrow.
Of course, of course. Oh, what's that? Faithful? Oh, no, no. Forever, the song of Blefuscu must be played at the wedding.
But, Bombo, Faithful is always played at our weddings. It's tradition, sir. And it's very pretty.
Yes, yes, I know. Pleasant little ditty, but hardly appropriate for this great occasion. But forever, there's a song for you. Ha ha!
Faithful will be played.
Bah, twaddle. Absolute twaddle. It must be forever.
Faithful.
Forever.
Faithful.
Forever. It will be forever a
there will be no wedding.
No wedding, but the cake and the pretty flowers and... Oh, Bombo, you love Faithful. I don't believe.
Gentlemen, but it's war.
War? Whoopee!
Forever, forever, there won't be anyone but you. Remember, I'm true, my sweet.
Shoo.
A war? Do you suppose he can be a spy?
Or he bothered me with passion, touching it. Who's a spy?
The giant on the beach!
Giant?
giant. Why don't you tell me these things? Do something. Don't stand there. Go, sick the dogs on. Fetch them to me at once.
Listen. giant on the beat!
There isn't a moment to waste. Every last man must do all that he can, work with the greatest of haste. So bind up its hands, its arms, its chest, its neck, its feet, and I'll do the rest. Let's go!
Thank you.
Your Majesty, I don't think he'd fit in here.
Oh, you don't, huh? So it's not good enough for him, hmm? Well, where is he?
Out there, Your Majesty.
Now then. Not good enough for him. Where is he?
From here on.
Call out the guards, the army, the navy, women and children first. I'll see you later.
Is going to hurt you.
Help! Put me down! Help! Help!
Drop that! Drop that!
Well, another one. Who are you?
Who, me? What? I'm king around here. Guards! Guards! To the turret! Archers! Surround the giant! Surround the giant! Guards!
Well.
You'll pay for this. Ready?
Aim fire.
Aim.
How do you like that? Want some more? All right, let it go!
It's Bob! Bob! Close the gates! Man the battlements! Defend the city! We're attacked! We're attacked!
Back to your post! Get back there and fight!
We of Rufus Crew are not afraid of anything.
Well, there's everyone gone. This is no way to treat a harmless visitor.
We've won! Gabby! See, Gabby? They've gone. Yes, sir. Scared? Stiff?
Don't let my size frighten you. You, Your Majesty, surely you're not afraid of me. Well, good. Then let me present myself. My name is Gulliver, Your Majesty. Lemuel Gulliver, a shipwrecked sailor. At your service.
Well, welcome to Lilliput, Mr. Gulliver. Mr. Gulliver, can you fight?
Well, Your Majesty, I can lick anybody my size.
Ah, splendid, splendid. I don't think Bombo will give us any further trouble while you're around here. No, sir. He's on our side, Gabby. He's on our side. There's nothing to fear. The Mad Mountain's on our side.
Let's go.
understand that not until that giant is removed can our forces taste the sweet fruits of victory. Now then, it is up to you to carry this message to my spies in Lilliput. Be off, and may luck be with you. Get going!
Sorry the little princess isn't with us.
Yes, too bad. Too much excitement for one day.
Thank you.
dream all day.
Thank you.
Anybody in there?
Nobody here but just us. Chickens!
My, my. And a wedding broken by a melody? Incredible. Wait a minute. I have an idea that might turn this malice to a melody. Sing Faithful and Forever together as one song.
Will be a dead dog.
Ha! Now we are getting at somewhere.
Dear spies, destroy, crush, obliterate, annihilate.
Kill him.
I will attack at dawn.
Affectionately yours, Bombo.
Bombo's attack. Guards! Guards! Guards!
Bombo's attacking! Bombo's attacking! Bombo's attacking! It's war! Bombo's attacking! To arms! It's war! The enemy attacks! To the beach! To the beach! Bombo's attacking!
What?
Bombo attacking! War! It's war! To the beach! To the beach! The enemy attacks!
To defend Lilliput.
Hold it,
beach and wipe out that Bombo, that bunch of Blefuscuians, and tear them to pieces, and don't leave a man alive to tell the tale. Forward, march!
Aye, aye, sir. My.
Hey! Wait for me! Gulliver! Wait for me! Wait for me, Gulliver!
Peacefully. Listen. Hold your fire. Hear what I have to say. Order your men to lay down their arms. Must I make you listen?
Wait here, Glory.
David.
The powder.
David.
Poor, poor, foolish little people. Look what you've done. Now go ahead, break your nutshell heads over your songs. But did you have to break Glory's heart, King Little? Because you're thoughtless and selfish? And you, Bombo, oh mighty warrior, what have you won? You were too stubborn to think, too busy quarreling to lend ear to the harmony that might have been yours. Now, in your sorrow and despair, perhaps you'll listen to your songs as they might be sung.
Peoples of Blefuscu and Lilliput, with eternal gratitude and love in our hearts, we christen thee Gulliver!
It's a hap, hap, happy day. Okay, so how many times did you think of Disney films while watching Gulliver's Travels? I lost count. Snow White permeates the entire film, no doubt, but there were other Disneyisms as well. Take, for instance, the scene where the Lilliputians remove Gulliver from the beach. How did he not wake up? He's a heavier sleeper than Sleeping Beauty. Literally. And did Gabby sound kind of familiar? That's because he also gave voice to Goofy. Disney likenesses aside, there were a couple of other things that crossed my mind. What do Lilliputians do when not being visited by giants? They must have some sort of government, food services, shopping establishments, doctors and whatnot. All of that came to a screeching halt just to wait on Gulliver hand and foot. And King Bombo was totally into Salvador Dali. I mean, just look at that mustache. And finally, no matter how many times I see the Fleischer Brothers rotoscoping technique, I'm still amazed about how good it looks. Gulliver had such smooth motion. Imagine how it would have looked if Popeye had been cast in the role. In the early planning stages, this was going to be a film starring the spinach-loving sailor. But that idea was quickly dropped. I mean, really, who would they have used as a reference? Robin Williams wasn't even alive then. If you'd like to suggest a movie, give us your thoughts or comments, or would like to say hello, check us out on Facebook, Public Domain Theater, Twitter, @Cherokee_Jack, or YouTube, FL Warmer. You can now experience the show live, Public Domain Theater, live at Popcorn Noir in East Hampton, Massachusetts. It happens once a month. It's a lot of fun. The movie is free, and the food is excellent. Make sure to check out Popcorn Noir's website, www.easthamptonpopcorn.com, for showtimes. I can't get that song out of my head.
It's a happy day, my.
When animating the character of Gulliver, they used a technique that they called rollerblading. They invented rollerblading, and that's how they created rotoscoping. Rotoscoping. I should do that for me. It's a happy day. It's a happy day. It's a happy day. It's a happy day. Okay. So, how many times did you think of Disney film? All right, let's do it again.
Gulliver Smash.